Now we have already learned the cause of existence of the three states of matter. Now we will learn more about gaseous and liquid state and the laws which govern the behavior of these states of matter in detail. Solid state we will be studying in class 12. Now we are going to take up Boyle's law. Boyle's law gives the relationship between pressure and volume. With the help of this animation, we are showing you the relationship between volume and pressure. Here, pressure has increased, so volume has decreased. It shows that the pressure and volume are inversely proportional when temperature is held constant. Now we are decreasing the pressure, volume has increased. Again, earlier there was gas molecule, air. Now we have got gas molecules in it. This is a movable piston. Pressure gauge is showing the pressure. Now we are increasing the pressure, volume of the gas is decreasing. And observe carefully. At this moment, pressure is high. Now we are decreasing the pressure. And when we decrease the pressure, volume increases. And when volume increases, more space is available to the molecules. And if more space is available, then frequency will be less. Frequency means number of collisions per second. Next, we are taking the graph between pressure and volume. We are plotting the graph between pressure and volume at constant temperature. So we have got three curves. The first curve in the blue color is at 200 Kelvin. The second green curve we have got at 400 Kelvin. And third curve in red color is at 600 Kelvin. The value of K1, that is constant, constant means pressure into volume remains constant. This for each curve is different because for a given mass of the gas, it varies only with temperature. That is, for every curve, temperature is constant. But for different curves, temperature is different. And these curves are known as isotherm. Why we call them isotherm? Because they are plotted at constant temperature. Higher curves correspond to higher temperature. Because if temperature is higher, volume will be higher. Two conventional ways of graphically presenting Boyle's law has been shown in the above graph. The graph between pressure and 1 over volume is a straight line. Why it is a straight line? Because pressure is inversely proportional to volume. So pressure and 1 over V will be directly proportional. The first straight line we have got at temperature T1. Second straight line we have got at temperature T2. And third straight line in red color we have got at temperature T3. T3 is higher than T2, is higher than T1. At high pressure, gases deviate from Boyle's law, and under such conditions, a straight line is not obtained in this graph. Now we are going to take up effect of pressure on volume of 0.09 moles of CO2 gas at 300 Kelvin. This will prove Boyle's law. Pressure is 2 into 10 to the power 4 pascals. Volume is 112. And 1 over V is 8.9. PV is 22.40. So we are changing the pressure to 2.5, 3.5, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Correspondingly, volume is decreasing. Pressure is increasing, so volume is decreasing. So volume becomes 89.2, 64.2, 56.3, 37.4, 28.1 and 22.4 respectively. If you take 1 over V, the values are shown in the table. Now we want to show that PV remains constant. Check the value of PV for various values of P and V remains almost constant. 22.4, 22.3, 22.47, 22.50. So they are almost constant, which shows that the pressure into volume remains constant, which is Boyle's law. Let's take up numerical based on Boyle's law. A balloon is filled with hydrogen at room temperature. It will burst if the pressure exceeds 0.2 bar. If at 1 bar pressure the gas occupies 2.27 liters of volume, up to what volume can the balloon be expanded? Now, according to Boyle's law, the formula is P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 is 1 bar. If P1 is 1 bar and V1 will be 2.27 liters, P2 is 0.2 bar, then V2 will be equal to P1 V1 divided by P2. P1 is 1 bar, V1 is 2.27 liters divided by 0.2 bar comes out to be 11.35 liters. Since the balloon burst has 0.2 bar pressure, the volume of balloon should be less than 11.35 liters. Charles' law. Charles' law gives the relationship between absolute temperature and volume. Charles found that for all gases at any given pressure, graph of the volume versus absolute temperature is a straight line, and on expanding to zero volume, each line intercepts the temperature axis at -273.15 degrees centigrade. Slopes of these lines obtained at different pressures are different, but at zero volume, all the lines meet at temperature axis at 273.15 degrees centigrade. This experiment is showing the relationship between volume and temperature at constant pressure. In the first case, temperature is T1 and volume is V1, and you can very well observe that volume is less at temperature T1. In the second case, we are heating. In first case also we were heating, but temperature was low. In second case, heating is being done at larger flame and temperature T2 is higher. And when temperature T2 is higher, volume V2 is also higher. It clearly shows that the volume is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Each line of the volume versus temperature graph is called isobar. Why we call it isobar? Because it is plotted at constant pressure. Now, this diagram shows the relationship between volume and temperature. We are plotting a graph between volume and temperature in centigrade, and we get the various straight lines, but they are at different pressure. The first purple line we are getting at pressure P1, second red line we are getting at pressure P2, third green line we are getting at pressure P3, and fourth blue line we are getting at pressure P4. P1 is less than P2, is less than P3, is less than P4. So, observation of Charles' law can be interpreted if we put the values of T in the equation as 273.15 degrees centigrade. We can also observe carefully that the volume of gas at 273.15 degrees centigrade will become zero. This means that the gas will not exist. In fact, all the gases get liquefied before this temperature is reached. As we have discussed earlier, that when we are decreasing the temperature and increasing the pressure, the gas will be liquefied, that is, it will change to liquid. So, at absolute zero, that is 273.15 degrees centigrade, with all -273.15 degrees centigrade, all gases will become liquid. And that's why we assume that they have got zero volume. The lowest hypothetical or imaginary temperature at which gases are supposed to occupy zero volume is called absolute zero. All gases obey Charles' law at very low pressure and high temperature.